was unidentified man went berserk last night, opening fire with a 12-gauge shotgun in a crowded downtown restaurant. 14 people are dead, including 3 children. 4 others suffered serious injuries. Police have a suspect in custody, but are not releasing any information until they complete their investigation. A government bill to crack down on laboratory experiments on animals is expected to become law today. Animal rights activists have been pushing for the bill for 9 years and are taking part in mass demonstrations throughout the nation. It's expected the bill will outline just what animals will be allowed to be used in the labs, along with penalties for the bill.
About a dozen downtown businesses were boarded up Wednesday, and glass-littered sidewalks following 2 nights of protests over the police shooting of an unarmed black man. There were few people on the streets as the Cincinnati Archdiocese canceled classes.
To all law enforcement across America, the killers have got to stop.
Are you in there? Puppy.
Who is it?
It's me, Max.
Better 3 hours too soon and a minute too late.
Sorry. Mom said I should just come around. Should I come back tomorrow?
Go. Your mother should know I got better things to do. Your turn.
King of the Hill.
See a good move, look for a better one. You have to develop all your pieces.
I thought I had it.
It was good. But were you not judging too soon? I knew I should not have opened the door.
Seriously, Pap, you have to help me.
Aren't kids supposed to do their homework themselves?
I'm just not good. I don't know what to say. 1,000 words. I just can't do it.
You are right. If you are telling yourself you cannot do it, you will not be able to do it. You got a title.
My hero.
What would I know about heroes?
Maybe from when you were in the war or something.
Do you know something about the war?
A little.
A little?
Yeah.
What are they teaching you in Hebrew school? A little? Well, a lot happened in the space of the little you know.
You have to help me. Please.
I don't know. Maybe there might have been someone, but it was a long time ago.
No, that doesn't matter. Someone you knew.
Max.
Before you came to America.
Max, hold your horses. Okay? If you want to hear the story, let me tell it. Right? What's important is the man I want to tell you about. And that man lived in the city of Debrecen, Hungary.
Huh? You don't work?
You hear me? What do you say? And this particular man was nobody, an ordinary man. But the circumstances were extraordinary. His name was Sanson. He was a good worker. Young and strong. He would break rocks from dawn till dusk as the sun beat down on him, quietly doing as he was told. He kept himself to himself.
And you went to him?
Yes, I had to wring my shirt afterwards and it was full of mud.
He was a man of God. He was a lawyer, and who could have become a judge or mayor if he hadn't been living in the wrong time at the wrong place.
So how are we today? Making more trouble, making life harder for us all.
What do you mean?
Well, you know, isn't that what you do? When everyone goes right, you go left.
Listen, I don't need you. You don't need me. It's not your business what I do with my life.
Well, don't stop mixing with those guys, then.
Sanson, please. She's my sister. She just came to say hello.
Sorry.
See you tomorrow. You know, those guys and me, we're all your people. Only a coward turns his back on his people. You still believe in justice? Hmm?
You're not working with judges and politicians now. They won't let you back in town hall.
You're not a lawyer anymore, Sanson. You break rocks. This is a war. You need to fight.
She's been listening to the wireless. She just came to say that the Germans are on the ropes.
I don't want you speaking to Judith. I don't want you speaking to any of them, okay? It's not just us we have to think about now. I love you.
Sanson loved his city and his country, and most of all, his darling wife, Florence. his childhood sweetheart. Even the most envious souls would admit there was not a happier pair in Debrecen. But war turns people into animals. The city became a place of suspicion, distrust, and desperation. Only deep in the woods, surrounded by trees, could they feel free again.
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, asher kideshanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu lehadlik ner shel Shabbat. Amen.
Amen.
It's very difficult to talk about. But
who is it?
Judith. I know you said not to come here. This is important. Admiral Horthy returned from Klesheim yesterday. When he got here, he was greeted by German troops. Prime Minister Kalai has resigned.
And go on.
Hitler has given the order to invade. There are trains right now being set up to take us into camps. The Germans are coming.
Everyone was frightened. People had to show their loyalty to the Germans like never before.
Let women and children hold back. The journey will last only.
They were urged to hurry up while there were still jobs available at the destination. They promised to take care of their relatives left behind. They were promised anything just to get them on those trains. Some believed they would return to Hungary after the war. Others didn't know what to believe. Hardship was turning brother against brother, father against son. One wrong move in the wrong place and they were after you.
Forced all the Jews in the Jewish quarter. Now they're sending them away in trucks.
Just like in Poland.
Don't talk like that. We need to stay strong. And the Soviets?
We picked something up on the radio. Peace for us 2 months.
The Germans will have wiped us up by then. God knows the Chendos are doing everything they can to help them.
I overheard some Nazi officers yesterday. They said the police here have been more cooperative than anywhere they have ever been.
We have to find a way through.
London. London calling. London calling.
2 hours ago, Supreme Headquarters of the Allied Expeditionary Force gave news of our airborne landing in France. British, American, French, and Canadian forces have landed in northern France.
This is
General
great
Eisenhower
news.
Gave his next order, Paris.
Paris. By the time they get here, it might be too late for us.
After being told they would reach the Theresienstadt concentration.
Where are the Nazi headquarters?
It's by the main square. Let's have a look.
Show me.
Most of the remaining Jews were deported.
What is it? Mr. Kovac? Take a seat.
Will she live? How long will she stay here?
I'm sorry, Sonson. It's breast cancer. You know, we are old family friends, but drugs are in short supply now. You can trust me, I'll do all I can.
So you coming back from the woods the other day? Judith called you the best barrister in Hungary. We need people like you, smart people.
Look, I'm not interested. I don't want to be involved. She's very sick. She's the one who needs me. I wish I could just take you home. Maybe we should just leave now. I'll hide you in a blanket. And we'll escape. Oh no, I will, I will shrink you into a tiny person. I will shrink you into a tiny person and I'll put you in my pocket.
You don't have a pocket.
I do have a pocket. Oh, no, I don't have a pocket. You make me a pocket.
I want to go home. And you have to go to work.
Well, maybe you could come to work with me. Yeah, you should come to work with me. You can do all the hard work in the family. You all right? Sit up, sit up. Nurse! Nurse! Sit up. Sit up. Excuse me.
Please leave, sir.
Excuse me, calm down. Breathe slowly. Through your nose. Through your nose. Right.
I'm sorry to inform you, but unfortunately, due to the new regulations, I'm not allowed to give you any more treatment.
What new regulations?
There's nothing I can do. You're Jewish. I'm sorry.
Times have changed.
You need some meat to get your strength back. Go back to bed. Florence?
Florence? Have any wishes?
Yeah, I'm not sure about
it. Oh. I wish I could do something for all these people. I have something to ask you.
Thank you.
I want to end my life with pain.
Right now you need to rest.
No. I want to die without pain.
You're going to die. I'm just a little bit sick.
I'm sorry. I never meant to hurt you.
You couldn't hurt me. You could never hurt me because I love you. You more than anything in the world.
She's a good girl.
Lochein balrachami yastirei beseser kenofop leoilumi veitzror veitzror arayim et nishmoisoy adoinoy anachlosoy veuni agad mishkovoy beshuloim venoimar
Thank you.
For the first time in his life, he didn't know what to do.
Harris waited. Quiet. Then, the bakers and plumbers and shoe clerks and their wives struck. And as they went into the streets to build once more the barricade their fathers and grandfathers had built against the enemy.
Everybody, hands up! Hands up! Don't move! Next to the wall! Hands up! Don't move! To the wall! Hands up!
You're surrounded. Anybody who resists will be shot. Are there any more rebels hiding in the building?
Cut down her trees, ripped up her face, remembering these words. Come on, you sons of your country. The day of glory has arrived. The enemy is tyranny. Let's raise our flag in blood against it. Come, citizens of France. Form your line. Go on.
Get him out! Get him out! Move!
Get your hands off me!
Clear arrows! Move!
Keep moving!
Out of the truck!
Go!
Move! Come on, move!
Go! Ow!
Move. Get in.
Get in.
What? Ow, faster. Get his gun. Kill them. What?
Gestapo want me to hand over the female Jewish prisoners.
How urgently, sir?
4 to 5 days.
Sir, I think with the current military situation, the Gestapo will have other priorities.
You're prepared to disobey the orders?
We can say that the truck got attacked by the resistance. That we had to keep them here till we were sure we've eliminated them.
A few days, sir.
Sansón. Sansón. They raided our hideout. They chained us of the girls. We don't know what they will do to them. We need your help.
You just want to leave them with the Chandas? They'll kill them.
Sansón, Florence is dead. There's nothing anyone can do for her now. We need your help.
You know it's not just the resistance, right?
They're rounding up everyone. They have Yudif.
You're very kind. We appreciate it. Thank you.
Get out.
I take the
beggar.
No!
Let me help you.
Here we go.
Good girl.
Ready? Right, that down.
Ha 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 ha!
Wolf von Heine.
What's your name? Who's in charge here? Who is in charge here? Name and rank. What? Name and rank.
Yes?
Who's in charge here? Who's in charge here?
Name and...
Thank you, sir.
Anderson. Thank you. Come on. Who's in charge here?
Name and rank.
Yes, sir.
Assemble the prisoners in the hall. The SS are coming.
The SS?
Yes.
My name is Rolf von Heiden, General of the Deutsche Geheimdienst. In charge here?
I am, sir.
Name and rank?
Captain Havis, sir.
Captain Havis. I'm Rolf von Heiden, General of the Deutsche Geheimdienst.
Yes, sir. We'll do everything to assist you.
Captain Havis, are you aware of directives stating all prisoners must be treated humanely?
Yes, sir. We always treat our prisoners according to such a directive.
That's a lie. These men are criminals. They are animals.
Shh. Let us speak.
They starved us. They raped us. They're savages, all of them.
Is this true, Captain?
General, sir, you can't take the word of a Jew against that of a Xander officer.
It's true, sir, what I said. They're animals, rapists.
I'm looking for a woman, Judith Bartosz. She's a Jew.
I know her. They took her away somewhere.
Who?
They did.
Who?
Him.
I don't know anything about that. We treat all our prisoners according to the law.
What is this, sir?
You are all under arrest. Move. Move. On your knees.
Sir, I just obeyed the orders of my superior. That's what I was doing.
Judith Bartosz, where is she?
I don't know.
Judith Bartosz, where is she?
Sir, you are doing a big mistake.
Tell me or I will shoot you.
The Nazi took her.
Where?
What? Transport. Everyone from the ghetto has to be transported to Poland.
Must finish the fight.
Who are you? What are you going to do to me? What?
Let's go before the Chandras get here.
They're coming right now.
Okay. All right, take your positions. Come on. Come on.
Stand here, Robbie. Next to me. This.
Okay, be quiet. Quiet, shh, quiet.
Okay.
And you wait for my order. Wait for my order. Whatever happens, you keep firing till the last bullet.
Don't fire until I give the order.
On positions! Keep going!
Fire.
You play, they're not real heroes. The real heroes, they pick up a stick and the fist and they suffer for real. They fight when they can fight.
You're leaving, aren't you?
I have to. I made a promise.
Go to this address. You might be able to help you.
Who are they?
Bitars. Polish resistance. They know something about transportations coming from the south.
You continue the fight, my friend.
Thank you for all your help, my friend.
Of the Zionist Better Revisionist Movement.
We, the warriors of the Zionist Better Revisionist Movement.
In the name of Vladimir Jabotinsky.
Promise
to fight to the end.
Promise to fight to the end.
We will never surrender.
We will never surrender.
And we will give our lives for the honor of Apia.
We will.
Take your things and get out of here. Now!
A normal man would need at least a month to get from Debrecen to Poland on foot. Sansan did it in 8 days. He He would walk to the end of the world until he found Judith, alive or dead. Aronson, the leader of the Jewish ghetto, was ordered to evacuate 62 Jewish families from an apartment block by the end of the afternoon. He knew what the word evacuate meant, Auschwitz. It also meant that his wife and children could be on the same train if he failed.
Brother Ezra, greetings.
Aronson, what can we do for you?
Colonel Forbach has ordered this building to be cleared by tonight.
He asked for 5,000 victims, and you give him 10, just to save your own skin. If I don't give him what he wants, he will kill us all.
Please, sit down and stay there. Don't move.
Boys, please. Aronson, you, leader of the Jewish Council, charged with espionage and betrayal.
I saved 50 people, they killed 1,000. I saved 50 people, your cousin is here. Look, everybody's here.
You're sentenced to death.
Boys, listen to me.
Yes, you are.
No, no, please. No.
After 8 days on foot, Sanson arrived at the gates of the Polish ghetto.
Can I help you, sir?
To go to the ghetto. I'm going to the ghetto. The German police told me to go to the ghetto.
You go to the end and report to registration with the Jewish ghetto police.
Thank you.
My name is Sansan Kovacs. Was told to come here? My wife's sister was transported from Hungary to Poland.
Who are you?
I'm looking for Yuri Baltos. I was told to come here and ask for your help. You don't know? Can I have a glass of water, please?
Where did you get this?
My friend Yano, he said he might be able to help me. So maybe I can help you if you help me find Judith.
If it goes wrong, you're gonna get us all killed.
It won't go wrong.
How do you know?
I don't.
Good evening. We have orders from Colonel Forbeck. We're taking this Jew to headquarters for interrogation.
Where's the order?
Oh, yeah.
Can you read?
Herr General?
Herr Hitler, Colonel. I'm SS General Ludwig von Mannheim. I'm a coordinator of Herr Himmler's department. This is a letter from Herr Himmler, relieving you of your duties for failing to complete deportation of Jews to the east of Poland. You are to pass over command of the ghetto and all operations to me.
Very well, Herr General.
In 48 hours, you are to report back to Berlin with your immediate subordinate officer. Right now, he will brief me how many persons are in the ghetto, how many soldiers, food supply, weapons, munitions.
Yes, sir.
Good. Shall we?
At present, we have 49,000 Jews in the ghetto, but we expect more today. Some young women from Slovakia, a chance for our soldiers to take some pleasure. We were paid to take these Jews to Auschwitz by the Slovakian Prime Minister. And we wanted to do something for the morale of the troops.
Tell me, this Slovakian Prime Minister is a military man?
No, sir, he's a Nazi party leader. He's highly trusted in the Reich. He's helping us.
Go on.
At the moment, I have 285 soldiers under my command and 42 Jewish ghetto police, all very loyal to me.
And munition?
We have 855 weapons and enough food in our warehouses. However, we give nothing to the Jews in order to weaken them and make them want to leave for Auschwitz.
Oh, thank you for that insight, Colonel. Tell me, Jews transported here, the records, where are they?
They get sent straight to Berlin, of course.
Colonel Farbach, Captain Hochberg, delivering 1,800 Jewish females from Slovakia.
It was supposed to be 3,000.
Some of them resisted, sir. We had to eliminate them.
Oh, Colonel.
Herr General.
You're under arrest.
Under arrest?
There must be some mistake.
Telegram from Gestapo High Command in Berlin. You confiscated gold and silver antiques, and then you sent it to your wife.
But that was from Jews. I took those from Jews, not the Reich.
Colonel, please, don't pretend you don't know the law. Everything that is stolen from the Jews, it belongs to the Reich. It's a very serious crime. Take him away.
Herr General! Herr General! Herr General! Das ist ja nicht zu glauben! Das ist eine klar, eine Verschwörung! Das können Sie mit mir nicht machen! Das werden Sie teuer zu stehen bekommen! Herr General! Das ist eine Verschwörung! Das wird Sie teuer!
I will have you arrested for this! Das ist Landesverrat!
Herr General! Ich rufe das Hauptquartier in Berlin an! Das hat ein Nachspiel!
Shut up! Das werdet ihr bereuen.
Runter mit euch! Schnell, wieder runter! Ella! Und weiter!
How do you think it means him coming here?
I don't know.
You think they're taking gas to Auschwitz?
Auschwitz?
Where the gas, the Jews?
Gas?
Yes, yes. Men, women, children, even babies.
I thought the Germans are civilized. So did I. Remember when we had a chance to leave Germany? Now, look at us.
Don't panic, brothers. I'm better. So is he. You want to fight the Germans? If we don't, we're all dead. Go to synagogue. This afternoon.
The Betters are taking control of the ghetto now. Anyone who is young and fit must report to us and help to win this war.
But how?
How do we defeat them?
where we don't just sit around and wait for the Russians to come. We fight. Now we fight back.
I'm with you. The general's plans worked. We have kept to the headquarters. I'm gonna go tell the others.
Like a fatally wounded animal, destroying everything in its path. The Germans were in retreat across Poland. Sanson and Ezra's ragtag army had to try to hold them off until the Russians caught up.
Word is spreading. Our numbers have grown. Men and women like you are leaving your towns and your villages and coming here to join our fight. And now we have control of the ghetto.
Let's move out. We have work to do.
We can do it. Yeah. For now. Do you have guns?
A few rifles, pistols, shotguns, bread knives. Everybody's got something. I had word this evening from my contact in the Polish underground army. It might be about Judith. He told me that trains from the south are being routed directly to the camps. I'm sorry. We should get our positions ready.
Germans will be here in the morning.
Make sure your weapons are loaded and ready to fire. Use them wisely. Make sure every bullet counts. Our enemies, they're outside this wall. They want to kill us. Now, I know you're scared. But you must have courage. No longer will they decide our future. Today we decide. Today we stand up and we fight.
Infantry and armor coming in from the south. Lots of men and tanks.
Get to your positions.
They'll be here in 5 minutes.
Go! Yeah, stay back, stay back.
Find your cover. Conserve your ammunition. What we talked
about. Get to cover! Keep your heads down. Larek, stop my share. We need them in the square.
Stay with me. Stay with me.
You don't have a pocket.
You make me a pocket.
Doctor!
You have to save her.
Nothing I can do. Your choice.
Sonson, wake up!
It's me. It's Judith. I escaped from the train. And I hid. I heard about the uprising, about you. And then I came here with others.
Ezra! Ezra! I'm running out of bullets!
Get in there!
You all right? You all right?
Yeah. This is bad, not good.
Sonson killed his last German soldier on May 16, 1944. There is something in each of us. Something that can make us do extraordinary things we would never be able to do without. For Sonson, that thing was immense and eternal love for his wife, Florence. All he wanted was to be back home, where people used to proudly say hello to him when they met him on the street, where children used to beg him to play with them,
We missed you at the ceremony. They are saying you were sent by God.
I'm just an ordinary man, Ezra. Just an ordinary man.
She knew she was his only link to the one he loved, and that he would never take his eyes off her again.
Didn't you see him again?
Life goes on. And look, it's getting late.
But how is it you know him? Were you in Poland too?
My story is not so interesting. Come on, your mother will be wondering where you are.
Abby.
It's time for me to rest. Come round again, I'll tell you another story.
Happen again.
I believe it could. That's why we need you to be strong.
Una mañana, mañana, hay un catán, así llamo ella. Hogyha ilyen ketten állunk, Isten tudja, mit csinálunk a sötétbe. Hogyha ilyen ketten állunk, kicsi csiprókat csinálunk a sötétbe. Ó, ne menj el, ne menj el, maradj velem az ilyen.